So my work is primarily focused on conservation of tropical forests, mainly in the Amazon basin. What I learned doing work with indigenous communities, with government actors, with scientists trying to advance conservation in tropical rainforests is that to do it successfully, you need to have a strong understanding of science, an understanding of society, of how people work, an understanding of politics, and it all needs to come together to make environmental progress, to make environmental policy that works for people and that works for the planet.
In environmental studies, I have taken classes in philosophy, sociology, history, statistics, biology.
As a geologist, I have been able to teach a number of courses that deal with geologic time, that is the 4.5 billion years that the Earth has been here. Those courses deal with the interplay of the climate over that period of time, but in environmental studies, I'm able to take that one step further and deal with climate change in the ways that it is affecting humanity today and projecting those changes out into the future.
Climate change, biodiversity conservation, marine management, all of these issues require students to be able to approach a problem from a variety of different disciplinary lenses. The environmental studies major starts out with training in subjects including history, statistics, economics, political science, and policy. From there, students take elective courses where they're able to follow along with a particular pathway of interest.
Between the core requirements and the electives I get to choose, I can pursue any different avenue I want and get a good mix of different classes. So environmental studies pairs well with a lot of majors. It was flexible with my schedule. It was classes that were flexible with my interests, get a taste for philosophy or maybe even get some real world application with statistics all through the environmental lens. People I met in the intro class and throughout like outing club and other extracurriculars on campus who also happened to be majors. We would discuss stuff outside of class that was just of relevance to us. It felt more like a community than a lot of other majors who just took classes together.
You're gonna also find a lot of different people, like even within the major, the diversity of students and like the perspectives they bring to the major is really cool.
Whether you're interested in getting involved in policy, getting involved in doing cutting edge ecological research that's gonna help us solve the climate crisis, whether you're interested in learning more about renewable energy, this is a place that can create opportunities for you. Not just in the classroom, but outside of it.
I was really fortunate and lucky to have the opportunity to go to Ghana and to do research there on the ground, understanding of what does the agricultural development strategy for Ghana look like. From a national level, all the way down to the district and the village level and talking to people, I was really able to like get an appreciation for what it is they're going through, how the projects, the agricultural development projects are helping them, how what the shortcomings of the projects are. And that was cool because I can then marry that to what I did in the classroom in global environmental politics.
Whether it's going out into the field and doing work with communities, and there's opportunities to do that, or going to more established policy think tanks over your summers to try to understand what it is that the most innovative people and thinkers are doing to try to confront climate change and develop renewable energy or protect threatened ecosystems, this is a place that can plug you in to these cutting-edge spaces for innovative thinking and action at the end of the day.